out of Async Task class now. We're gonna see this in action. For that, I'm going to create a new application. I'm gonna name it my new Async Demo. And I'm gonna create empty activity and finish. So in this particular example, I'm going to create a button which will open up my progress dialog only. And if you remember that in our user control session, we did create a progress dialog, but we were not able to update it. So here, we are going to update that progress dialog. I told you we will do it in Async Task class. So now is the time. So we will update it with the help of Async Task class by putting it in the doInBackground method. For first thing first, I will create a nice UI here. I'll call it Async Task. And let me just increase this font size, 30 SP. And I'm gonna create a button here, which will invoke my Async Task class, open progress dialog. And let's just make it match parent. And in the on click of this button I want, so I will go into the XML part, type on click, and do something. Yeah, and just click on the text and press Alt Enter. There you go, method is created for you. Now, inside this method, I will put the code to execute my Async Task class, but for that I need to create my Async Task class first. So if you think your Async Task class is only going to be used by this particular activity only, go ahead and create your Async Task class right here as inner class. But if you think that it's going to be used by other activities also, then you might want to create it as a separate class. So how do you do that? Right click in your development package, go to new, create a normal Java class. Let me just call it my progress task. And this is just a Java class right now. You will extend it with Async Task. Now, here, before right away putting the overrided method, that is doInBackground, you will put the parameter. Three parameters are there, param, progress, and your result. So what is the param right now? I just want to update my progress bar, so I don't really need a param right now, but yeah, in further sessions you will see that if you want to connect to internet or you want to connect to a database, at that point of time this param will be a data type. Like connecting to internet, might you might want a string, that is a URL, right? For connecting to database, you might want a cursor object, or you can say a query, right? Progress, you need an integer, because I want to update the progress bar, so it's an integer right now. And result, let's just put string. What kind of result it will be? If your progress bar is successfully updated, it will return you a string successful. Otherwise, it will return you a string failure. So now let's just click on implement methods. Now there is only one method, doInBackground. There you go. That's the only abstract method you have in my progress task. But you can override other methods like on, pre-execute, that will be executed before your doInBackground is called, or you can override on post-execute. So on pre-execute will be called before your doInBackground. So if you want to put any UI operation here, so what kind of UI operation I would want here? Well, I want to show a progress dialog. So I will show my progress dialog inside on pre-execute. I cannot show my progress dialog inside my doInBackground as it is working in worker thread. And I also want on post execute. So this method here will be called every time once your doInBackground is finished. So here in this particular example, I am updating the progress bar frequently, you know, as it progresses. Once it gets whatever the update it's getting updated, you know, frequently. So that means from inside your doInBackground, I'm always coming back to my main thread. So the method which does it for you is on progress update. So we will see how exactly this on progress update also is being used. So these are the methods which I require for my particular example, in this example. So now before I go further, let me just create a constructor of this class, public my progress task, and in this, inside this constructor, I'll create a context object. Why do I need context object? So at any point of time, let's say inside this progress bar, at any point of time, let's say you want inside this async task class a context object. Maybe you want to show a toast, or you want to show a progress dialog. They require context object. So that's the reason you will be passing it as a constructor. So wherever you create an object of this class, you will inside activity especially, you will be getting the context object there. So let me say CTX here as a global context object, and progress dialog I need, so PD. Here, CTX equals to CT. So that's that takes care of your context object. Second, I need to show my progress dialog. That's something I can do here in my pre-execute. So how do I show a progress dialog? New. Progress dialog and pass the context. I cannot pass this here because it's not an activity. So for that very reason, we have this context CTX. Now pd.setTitle. We can put title as, let's say, what kind of title you want? I want, let's say, downloading. And pd.setMessage, let's say, please wait. And pd.setButton, it's just like we did in user control. I will put the progress or button type, let's say negative, call it cancel. And handle it new on click listener. Just want to close your progress dialog, so dialog interface dot cancel, and at the end pd dot show. So by default, it will your progress dialog will have from 0 to 100. The progress max, you can set the max as set max as 10, so it will be 0 to 10 now. Okay, so my progress dialog is good to go. I mean, it will be shown to you on the screen. But the only thing you need is, you need it to be, sorry. The only thing you need is, now is, you need it to update itself. So for, I'm using for loop right now, but in your real example, in your corporate applications, you won't be updating your progress dialog with just a for loop. You will be using, let's say you are downloading a file from internet, your length of the file and speed of the network will determine how much or what is the time it's going to take to update or download that particular file. Here in this particular example, I will just put a thread to sleep for a few seconds, and after that I will again update my progress bar. And again, it will, next time it comes to the loop, again, it will sleep for a few seconds, and again, it will update. So I just want to show that you can update your UI or update your progress bar with the help of async task class. But when you will be doing this in real life, you will be using a different mechanism, but the methods to update your UI will remain same, just like we are using here. So, I will use a thread to sleep here, thread.sleep, to give you an appearance that it's gonna take time. So here I can put any time here. I do know that if you do not update your UI within 16 milliseconds, it will generate ANR, or there are components like broadcast receiver which can wait for 5 seconds. Let's just wait 7 seconds here, which is violating all the ETA times which we have in components. So even after 7 seconds, your application will not generate ANR, and it will, after 7 seconds, it will update itself. Now you can see there is an error. That error is your thread.sleep generates an exception, that is try and catch. So I will put this whole statement in try and catch for loop statement also. Catch exception E. And you can put a log regarding that, you know, exception and e.getMessage. Okay, and once you do that, you can put as null. Okay. You don't require this as of right now. let's say if somebody reaches to exception, you want to return failure. Okay, now it will sleep for 7 seconds. Okay, at the same time, you want to log also so that you can see that your loop is actually running. Thread execute I. Now you, after 7 seconds, you want to update your progress bar, but you know that the only way to update from within the doing background is you have to somehow call your on progress update. So how do one calls this on progress update? Well, for that, publish progress is the method, and here you will be passing the integer values you want to update, let's say I. Now this I here will get passed here inside your as soon as it sees this publish progress, it will start searching for on progress update, and it will pass whatever the value you are passing inside this in where aware concept. What exactly do I mean where aware concept? Let's say you are doing multi-threading, you are progressing more than one progress bar. So at that point of time, there may be a J, there may be another integer value, you know, all these values will be passed directly inside this values parameter as an array, and then you can access them with the help of for each loop inside this progress update. For our particular example, I don't need this, I just need one. So I will just handle it int my value equals to values, and it will be at 0th position. Okay, so now I have my value in my value variable. All I need is pd.setProgress. And once you do that, what's the progress? My value. And there you go. It will set that particular progress. Let's say for the very first time, it will be, okay, let me make it one. It will be one, and it waits for 7 seconds to update itself as one value and publish, and it will go to your progress dialog. It will set the progress, and again, it will come back and it sees the closing braces of for loop. It will increment the I, it will be two now. Again, it will sleep for 7 seconds. Again, it will log this statement and publish and update your progress bar. And this process will go on till it reaches to 10. And after that, just return successfully. If this might not be the best way to, place to declare this, but yeah. You get the point that you just need to return a string value here, because that's what we have defined at the starting, that this is string. So the return type of doInBackground will also be string. And this is void, the param. That's why the parameter you are passing is void. If this would have been string, it would be string. If this would have been integer or bitmap, this would have been also bitmap. And this is integer because here it is integer. Okay, got it. And the last thing, that is post execute, it's string because the return type or the result is string. So now you can just put a toast here, toast matrix, and you call it, let's say you want a context object, so ctx, and call it your message, and duration is, let's say, length short and dot show. There you go. So you see now it will show toast, and at the same time, let's say you do want to exit your dialog box, so you need to dismiss it after your, you know, progress is complete. You want to dismiss it. So let's just see this in action now. Run our application and open your logcat, see whatever's going on in your Android device now when your application runs. Okay, still there is a problem in this particular exam, that when you click on this button, nothing happens. Why? Because you never invoked this async task class here. Right, so how can I invoke my async task class here? For that, I will do what? My progress, I will need the object of this, let's say p1, and here all I need is p1 equals to new my progress, and it will need a context object now. So activity got a context object, so this I can do, And to execute your async task class, to trigger your async task class, we have a method name execute. Now, as you can see, I'm putting void here. I'm not putting any parameters because this is void here as param. But if this would have been a string, I would pass a string here. And I can pass string arrays to do the multi-threading also. But for our example, it will be just execute right now. So let's just see now. Run this again. Now open this. Okay, one more thing. We forgot that this is a spinner style which is coming right now. Well, spinner style will never let you know that if it is progressing or not, right? So here, by default, it always comes as spinner, right? So we did that in UI control. So again, progress style, you need to do progress style horizontal. There you go. Now we are good to go. See here. This time open, you can see there is a horizontal. It will wait for 7 seconds to update itself. Okay, I guess the application is not. Okay. The application is not installed properly. Let me just install it again. And it should wait for 7 seconds before it updates itself. Yeah, see, after 7 seconds, it will again update itself. Yeah, so, and if you want to see in the logcat, you can see that thread is being executed here. Now, one problem here, even if I cancel it here now, let's say I have canceled it, your thread will not stop. Your thread will always get executed even after 7, you know. What's the problem here? Even you have closed that. The problem is when you close your dialog box, you didn't close this. I mean, you didn't cancel your async task class. So how can I do that? All you have to do is cancel, put true here. That's it. And let's just put the time a little bit slower here this time. Maybe 100. Okay, 1 second at a time. So stop it and again run this. Open it and you see it's executing now. If you cancel it right now, there you go. After 4, it won't execute because your async task also has been stopped. If you let it execute all the way, your progress dialog will dismiss. There you go. Right? So this was a small demo on async task class, and this demo must have helped you how exactly you can use async task class. And in your further examples, like connecting to the internet or connecting to servers and all, you will be under the hood, the skeleton will remain same. That's how you are going to use it. So I hope you try the same examples with other complex examples also. So that was it for my side for async task class. Thank you.